The 24th of June, 1806, Midsummer Day, began as just another day in Oddingley, a typical rural parish in the Midlands. Farmers were preparing for the clover harvest. Labourers were burning bonfires, building ricks and hacking thistles away from the growing crops. It was also an ordinary day for Reverend George Parker, the parish clergyman, who left his rectory home at 5 o'clock, as he did every day, on a short walk to his glebe meadows to collect his little herd of cows and drive them home for milking. A few minutes later, a gunshot rang out across the fields, followed shortly by a cry of murder. Two passing butchers were first to the scene. There they found the dying reverend, his side freckled with shotgun pellets and his head beaten in. They also saw, frantically trying to escape the scene, a man in a long blue coat. This man was chased, but he was not caught, and what happened to him thereafter became as much of a mystery as his motive for the attack. An inquest followed, and increasing rewards were advertised, but the truth of what happened that day would continue to be hidden for years to come. It was a day that came to define lives and gave rise to a local legend that the village was somehow cursed, somehow damned. It took more than 2 decades for the truth to emerge, and when it did, the story shocked the nation and dominated newspapers. In time, it became known as one of the most sensational crimes of the age, and it left the name Oddingley blackened throughout the land.